This is Dr. Arpana Chaturvedi from the Department of Information Technology. The subject which I am taking is Artificial Intelligence. And in this, we talk about export system. So today we will be talking about export system shell. And you know about the export system, that in export system, this human expert gathers the knowledge from the knowledge engineer. And whatever best knowledge it can acquire related to that domain, it collects and store it in a knowledge base. This end user asks the query through the user interface. This query goes to inference engine. This inference engine refers to the knowledge base, and on the basis of all the rules which are being stored over here in the form of if then else, it deduce or conclude to some fact and gives the output in the form of advice to the user. So an expert system is a piece of software which uses database of expert knowledge to offer advice or make decision in such areas as medical diagnosis, finance, coding, gaming, etc. So the main components of expert systems are knowledge base, inference engine, and user interface, which we have seen earlier also. And if we talk about expert system shell, so the expert system shell is a special purpose tool which is designed based on the requirement of a particular application or domain. And a new expert system can be developed by adding domain knowledge to the shell. So the shell refers to a software module which contains an interface, an inference engine, and a structured skeleton of a knowledge base with the appropriate knowledge representation facilities. Expert system shell can be viewed as an empty bowl that is yet to be filled. How it should be filled? It should be filled with the expert knowledge with related to a particular domain, that along with the inference engine, which may be used to process user request to generate solution to the user problem. So here, the expert system shell, where you can see that here is the expert, here is a user. So this expert will provide as much of as knowledge related to that domain to the system. Here is a knowledge acquisition subsystem which is responsible to acquire knowledge from different experts, scholars of that particular domain, and provide the knowledge to the, or store the knowledge in the knowledge base. Here it's an inference engine which do reasoning that what happens if this condition is true, and accordingly checking all the conditions, it will be going to provide the result. Here one more component is over there, that is explanation subsystem, which is responsible to provide the appropriate output after checking all the detail of a query given by the user. Fine, so that nothing should be left. So explanation subsystem is responsible to provide or check all different kind of explanation with respect to the query which is being given by the user with the help of user interface to get a advice from the expert system. Here is a user interface through which user gives the input and get the output, and here is an end user. One by one we will see each and every component of an expert system shell. So expert system shell is a software, as I said, software development environment. It contains the basic components of expert system. Shell is always associated with a prescribed method for building application by configuring and instantiating following components. What are those components? Those components are generic and core components. When I talk about generic components, those are knowledge acquisition subsystem, knowledge base, inference engine, explanation subsystem, and user interface. Whereas if we talk about core components, those are knowledge base and reasoning engine. So in this, if we talk about knowledge acquisition system, which is the first generic component, it is the first and fundamental step. This is a subsystem that helps experts to build a knowledge base. It helps to collect the expert knowledge required to solve problem and build the knowledge base. It collects all knowledge with from various experts which are related to that domain, which are having expertise in that particular domain, and represent it into knowledge base using different knowledge representation language like predicate and proposition log, or there are many more. Semantic network is there, framework is over there, script is over there. So whatever knowledge representation language it is using that, it collects the information from all various experts of that particular domain and represent it into knowledge base. The process of collecting the relevant domain knowledge needed to be solve problems and building the knowledge base continues to present the biggest bottleneck in building expert system. Next is knowledge base, which is also known as heart of expert system. It stores all factual as well as heuristic knowledge. Factual is a static knowledge and heuristic is a dynamic knowledge which keep on changing as we keep on updating the system also. It depends upon prediction about the application domain. An expert system shell provides one or more knowledge representation scheme for expressing knowledge about the application domain. Hence, we say it provides with the various representation scheme for all the data. Next is your inference mechanism. So this inference mechanism or engine is the brain of expert system. As knowledge base is the heart of expert system, it's the brain of expert system. This component is mainly responsible for generating conclusion or inferences from the given knowledge, which is being stored in the knowledge base, and produce line of reasoning in terms of the result of the user's query in the form of advice. This refers to the inference mechanism that are used for manipulating the symbolic information and knowledge contained in the knowledge base in order to form a reasoning path towards the solution of a problem. The inference mechanism can range from simple modus ponens, backward chaining, forward chaining, or if-then rules to more complex case-based reasoning. And if we talk about forward chaining is what? It is a strategy of an expert system to answer the question, what can happen next? We have to reach to the goal. We are having a query, we are having a problem for which we are looking at the solution. So how we can move forward? So we have to ask what can happen next, and step wise we can keep on moving ahead till we will not be able to deduce some outcome. So inference engine follows the chain of conditions and derivation and finally concludes to some output. It considers all the facts and rules which are being stored in the inference engine and sorts them before concluding to the final solution. This strategy is followed for working on conclusion, results or effects. For example, as I told you earlier also, prediction of share market status as an effect of change in interest rates. And backward chaining, with this strategy, an expert system find out the answer to the question. Why this has happened? So we are going back. Why this? What is the reason? What is the cause behind it? And on the basis of what has already been happened, the inference engine tries to find out which condition could have happened in the past for getting that result. So this strategy is followed for finding out main cause of the happening because of which something has been occurred, some kind of problem has been faced. For example, diagnosis of blood cancer in human. The human being is encountered with or come to know about the blood cancer. Now, we have to diagnose why the patient is having blood cancer. What are the different probabilities or the situations because of which the blood cancer has been occurred in a human being? Then explanation subsystem. This part of shell is responsible for explaining or justifying the final or intermediate result of user query. It is also responsible to justify the need of additional knowledge. This explanation subsystem explains the solution or result to the user or non-expert person. It explains the result or solution into why and how. Because explanation is required. Why this has happened? How this has happened? What is the reason behind? So here the explanation subsystem works, which gives the reason. This happened because of this. this is how it has been happened, this is the reason behind. So it gives reason why a certain cause of action or a certain conclusion was chosen, in which all circumstances, and how the solution is chosen by an expert system. User interface, as you very well know, that it represents a mean of communication with the user. It decides the utility of expert system. The user enters a request in natural language form, and the expert system processes the request to provide a result by using the inference rules to select the appropriate solution from the knowledge base. And user interface represents that solution in natural language. And on the basis of this, we conclude that building an expert system by using shells have significant advantages. It is always advisable to use shell to develop expert system, as it avoids building the system from scratch. To build an expert system using system shell, one needs to enter all necessary knowledge about the task domain into the shell. And this is all about expert system shell. Thank you. Have a nice day.